Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Alex from Pulsar Propulsion Labs, and today we're starting a new video series that I'm gonna call Rocketry for Absolute Beginners. This series is for anybody who wants to get into rocketry or even people that are already in rocketry that want a place to point beginners. Because when I was starting out, it seemed like there were resources all over the place, you know, some things on the rocketry forum, some things on YouTube, but there was no one consolidated place where you could go and just read about rocketry and pick up the hobby and go step by step by step and sort of build your skills. So that's what this aims to be. So for this series, I'm gonna try to keep it between 5 to 10 minutes per video to make things easy to digest and easy to reference in the future. But naturally, as things go, I'm sure there's gonna be a video or two that's a little longer. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. So first of all, what is rocketry? Well, rocketry is a hobby that started back in the space race era when amateurs wanted to emulate what they were seeing on TV and in the news. Most often in model rocketry, you're building the body of the rocket with its fins, its internals, and some sort of recovery system that's gonna bring it back from the sky safely. One common misconception about rocketry is that people are making their own propellant. And although this is the case for some experienced individuals, they're in the minority. Making propellant is extremely dangerous and can go wrong pretty quickly, so it's not something that is for beginners. Most people purchase their rocket motors from rocketry vendors. Notice I said motor, not engine. That's because it doesn't have any moving parts. This is an example of a model rocket motor. It contains a solid propellant that burns and lifts the rocket into the sky. But we'll talk about that in another video. Another awesome thing about model rockets is that they're reusable. After you get it back, just stick another motor in it and you're good to go again. Rocket motors come in many different sizes and are classified based on the amount of power that they produce. They're labeled from letters A through O, with each letter being twice as powerful as the one before it. But we'll talk about that in the next video. Typically, rockets are broken up into three different classes: low power, mid power, and high power. You might think that the main difference between those rockets is their size, and you wouldn't be entirely wrong, but the real main difference is the size of the motor that they fly on. Low power rockets fly on motors labeled A through D, mid power on E through G, and a high power H through O and above. So you might be thinking, how is all of this legal? What if it hits a plane? What if someone gets hurt? What if someone's property gets damaged? Believe it or not, even a rocket the size of this one can puncture the roof of a car. There are two main organizations in the United States that help make rocketry safe. Those organizations are the National Association of Rocketry and Tripoli. They provide a set of safety protocols that need to be followed at all times during a launch. And they provide an insurance policy should something go wrong at a launch. All right, so let's talk about how you can get started. Most people start with low power and work their way up, but that's not the only way to do it. It's definitely possible to get started with high power. To get started with low power, you'll need a couple of tools: an X-Acto knife, a cutting mat, a ruler, a pencil, some wood glue, some plastic cement, and some paint. You'll also probably want to start with a kit. Estes provides a model rocket kit that comes with everything that you'd need: a launch pad, a launch controller, and two model rockets to get you started. I'll throw a link to all the tools and materials you need in the description below. That's it for this video. If you found it informative or you learned something new, consider liking and subscribing so that others can find the video too. In the next video, we're gonna cover model rocket motor classification. And in the video after that, we'll talk about how to launch your first model rocket. Thanks, guys. See you soon.